It's just cooler than the other kids in the class. My freaking GoPro just quit.
Yeah, nice.
Oh, that's an aggressive kickdown. Very nice.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are taking a look at the all new. We're a bit late to the party, but anyway, Aston Martin is late to the SUV party as well, and so are we with the DBX party, because this is the Aston Martin DBX, a very important car for Aston Martin. We all know that financially Aston Martin has been struggling and has been given an injection by Lawrence Stroll and his investment business, whatever. Weirdly enough, because I think Aston Martin is actually, cars-wise, doing better than it has been in a long time. All the cars are just a joy to drive. They perform well, and they are absolutely drop-dead gorgeous. So today I'm going to show you around the all-new DBX. We're going to get in-depth a little bit with this car because there's a lot to talk about, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for a little Autobahn blast. Now, I have to say that the Autobahn blast is limited to around just over 200 kilometers an hour, but we're going to do a couple of 100 to 200 runs, of course, and listen to that gorgeous V8. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check us out on Instagram if you like, at Autotop.nl. All right, so let's start with the looks of the car, because Aston Martin going SUV is quite a big deal, of course, and the looks have been, well, debatable, really. I really like it. That's my personal opinion. I'm curious to see what you guys think of the looks. Let me know in the comments down below. I really, really like it. I think it looks very, like, muscly toned. It is very recognizable Aston Martin with the big grille and the big logo on the front as well. And we've got these gorgeous air vents in the hood as well. All these lines are very pronounced and very, like, sharp. Absolutely gorgeous. Now, a very cool design feature is that in here, these are the daytime running lights. And in there is actually a little air scoop that takes air and cools the brakes. So that is really, I really like that. I think that is super cool. They really try to give it like a sports car look. It has quite a, like, a sporty window angle. It has this beautiful sloping roofline, and this is all glass, which makes it look really cool as well. This car has been fitted with the lower and upper black pack, so that means that all these accents down here as well, the mirror caps, the windowsills, the roof rails, everything is black, which is a really good combination with this Arden green color, which I think is just gorgeous, man. Okay, so the wheels. We've got these 22-inch wheels, 285 section at the front with yellow brake calipers, regular steel brakes. This car weighs 2,100 kilos or 2,200 kilos. So it could use carbon ceramics if you go and drive on the track or if you go and drive a lot of high-speed stuff on the Autobahn. Other than that, I mean, if you don't do that stuff, the steel brakes work fine. It's got three-chamber air suspension as well. And that is a really good feature because it is super comfy, and it drops down quite a bit when you put it in sport mode, or it is raised quite a bit. I think it's raised 45 millimeters if you put it in terrain mode, and it is dropped 50 millimeters if you put it in sport plus. So that's quite a big difference, and the setup is really comfy. It's got an all aluminium bespoke DBX platform. And that means that the wheels have been pushed towards the corners, like Aston Martin always likes to do. And that is for better handling, of course, but also better proportions. Now, the rear is, yeah, I think this is the part people tend to have different opinions about, because it is quite weird, like, on an SUV having this, like, ducktail thing that is supposed to look like the V8 Vantage, like the new Vantage. But I think it looks great with those LED strip lights running in there, and it is very sporty. We've also got this wing here, and this has been designed also to not have a wiper here, which of course looks much better. We have the optional sport exhaust on this car, which looks absolutely gorgeous, poking through that rear bumper with those beautiful designed holes in them and this quite pronounced rear bumper lower part, almost like a diffuser. And we've got a little reversing light in there as well. But I really like this car. I think especially down the side, you can see with those creases and this part down here that they've tried to make it look like very muscly, but not big, not fat. It's supposed to look trimmed down, you know? It's supposed to look like it goes to the gym a lot. Ah, it's on this side. Okay. Weird. So let's take a look at the engine, which of course is the 4-liter twin turbocharged V8 from AMG. Now it does have an Aston Martin exhaust and it's got Aston Martin like tweaking, so they do have an influence on how the power plant feels. But in essence it is an AMG engine, as you know probably, with the hot V. You can actually see the turbochargers in there, 550 horsepower and 700 newton meters of torque, which is quite a lot. You can actually see the aluminium here, which is cool. Now, as I said, weighs around 2200 kilos, which it's not light, but it's also not that heavy for an SUV. But I guess the size, it's not as big as a Bentley Bentayga, which is one of the competitors, but it is bigger than a BMW X3M or something like that, you know? It's quite a nice size. And on the interior, we've got a gorgeous spec. The outside, as I said, is Arden green, and the interior, this is wolf gray with wood veneer in here, which is very light and contrasts nicely with the dark gray stuff and the gray leather. Contrast stitching as well. I mean, this interior is on a next level. This is so nice. It is so beautiful. It's beautifully made. The leather is great. The finishing is great. I mean, the panel gaps and stuff is very good, actually. The fit and finish. I like those holes in here for the speakers as well. Everything is covered in leather. We've got quite thick carpets. And this floating center console is really beautiful. With this storage down here, storage in here. These are also adjustable, as you can see. And we've got more Mercedes tech in here, because the infotainment is Mercedes as well. So we've got quite a few Mercedes bits in here, which, if you ask me, only makes the car better. I mean, this is quite an old system. It's the previous system from Mercedes, but it is better than the one you get in Avantage, for instance, because it's one generation newer, but everything you would need is in here. It's not the best system, but it is fine. It is a good system. I like the screen as well. It just looks modern enough, you know? In an Aston Martin, you're never going to get the cutting edge in infotainment stuff, but it really doesn't need it. If it's like this, it's absolutely fine. You can also use Apple CarPlay with the cable. So that's great. And we do have a lot of Aston Martin specific buttons down here, which look really cool. And well, I just love the interior spec on this car. So let's take it for a little drive towards the Autobahn. Of course, we've got the buttons up there. Now we've got a Mercedes gearbox as well, the ZF 9-speed gearbox automatic, which is really good, very comfy. It's not the best for like sporty driving, but for comfort, it's one of the best. Silky smooth. And well, there's some more serious tech in here to make this car handle and feel like an Aston Martin and not like a Mercedes. So it has the 48-volt anti-roll technology as well, which you can feel because the car stays nice and flat. It also has the transfer case, like a center differential from an AMG E63S. It's got an active rear E-diff with torque vectoring, and it's got a carbon fiber prop shaft hooked to that that center differential. So it's got some serious tech. Now this is GT mode, as you can hear. It's nice and quiet, but you do hear a little bit of that V8, that dirty V8 sound. we know and love from this engine. But as I said, it has an Aston Martin exhaust, so it does sound different from an AMG. So let me just demonstrate. We've got mode buttons down here. So if we go to Sport Plus, as I said, the air suspension lowers. And we can use the column mounted paddles here to shift, which are absolutely gorgeous. But listen to that. That sounds... that sounds really good. It's got a different tone to it than this engine in an AMG, which sounds really nice. Really love the sound. It's got that sports exhaust, as I said, which is an option, but I would definitely recommend getting that because it sounds nice and dark and a little bit of a crackle on the overrun as well and on the downshifts. Oh man, sounds really good. And there are a few things about this car that have been set up absolutely perfectly. One is the sound, the exhaust, but another thing is the chassis and the suspension, because the steering feel is really good. It's got quite a direct steering rack, 2.6 turns lock to lock, but the feel in there is absolutely amazing. And you don't really feel that weight because the steering is so good, because there's so little roll, because you've got quite a bit of power, of course. Oh, but if you throw this into a corner, it will absolutely stick. Okay, little sound. Okay, so I'll give you a little insight, a little behind the scenes info or peek behind the scenes. My freaking GoPro just quit. All of a sudden, it just turned off, didn't turn on again. I cooled it, it doesn't work. So I switched cameras. It might look a little bit different, but anyway. Boot space, 632 liters. Some more consumer advice for you. Look at that beautiful leather. Very nice. And you get a beautiful umbrella with it as well. Although I don't know if that's free or you have to pay for it, but anyway, it's a very practical car as well. And listen to that idle sound. That sounds awesome. Rear space, while I'm at it, very good as well. You can sit adults in here quite comfortably. Beautiful leather. Oh man, I love Aston Martins. They always make you feel so special and cool. And we've got this massive panoramic roof as well, which makes it feel really light in here, combined with that light leather on the roof, of course. Okay, so that was a little bit of an interruption. Don't know what happened. Hate it when that happens. Okay, here we go. I don't even know what I was talking about. I think it was the sound. And yeah, it sounds amazing. Absolutely amazing. Oh man. So if you compare it to, let's say, a Bentley Bentayga V8, a Range Rover Sport SVR, or maybe a regular Range Rover with the V8 supercharged, a Lamborghini Urus, I think this is, you know, this is the coolest one. It will always have that Aston Martin magic. It's just cooler than the other kids in the class, you know? It just always will be. And especially if you spec it like this. I mean, man, this is just insane. I've been driving it all week and I can't get used to it, you know? Every time I get in it, I'm like, yeah, nice. Just makes me happy. Okay. As I said, no top speed runs. Top speed is 290 kilometers an hour. I'm sure it will get there. 0 to 100, 4.5. We've been able to do a 4.4 run, so that delivers as well. Oh, that's an aggressive kickdown. So here we go. I'm going to warn you, fun will be over very soon because it is quite a quick car. But listen to that sound. Oh, man.
So we picked this car up at the Aston Martin Performance Center or Technology Center, whatever they call it, at the Nürburgring, which is about a 2.5 hour drive for us. So I got to test like the... Oh man, that downshift. I got to test like the comfort stuff as well if you put it in GT mode. And I can tell you that the air suspension and all the stuff that matters for the comfort is so good. The only thing is the seats, although they look amazing, I'm not sure about like for longer journeys, it's not that great. So I'll put it in GT mode now, so you can hear the difference as well with the exhaust closed. Now the air suspension raises again, which you can actually feel. And the suspension setup is super comfy now. When it's in sport mode, it feels like a much smaller car. It's like a, it almost feels like a Porsche Macan, you know? It has that same, yes, it's an SUV, but no, you can't really feel it, feel. All right, so this is GT mode. You can hear the valves are closed. And the car moves around a little bit more, you know, it bounces a little bit and just goes up and down. It's really nice and comfy. And I've got another mode for you guys to show, which is individual, which is basically sound with comfort mode. So the valves should be open now. Man, what a car. Honestly, if you're looking at a car in this, like the uber luxury SUV segment, I think this is the most special one. If you look at, you know, looks, interior, it's not the fastest, it's not the biggest, it's not the most practical one, but I do think it's the most special one. Okay, we're going back to Sport Plus because I feel like if you do accelerations, you should be in Sport Plus. So this is a super important car for Aston Martin, as I said in the beginning, because the SUVs, I mean, like it or not, they usually are the cash cow for these brands. So like the Porsche Cayenne actually did so much for Porsche. It's insane how many Cayennes they sell. If you look at Bentley, over half their sales are Bentaygas. For Lamborghini, the Urus is an absolute cash cow. So even though Aston Martin is a bit late to the party, I hope that it will bring them what they need, because this is such a special brand and these cars are so cool and fun to drive. And I think that Aston Martin is in a really good place right now, because they've got all that Mercedes tech, so they don't have to worry about that. They don't have to design their own infotainment, which is a really difficult thing to do. They can just focus on making them look cool, making the interiors cool with all that beautiful leather, and getting, you know, that V8 from AMG, which is in the Vantage as well, in the DB11, and now in the DBX. It is a magnificent engine, and it fits Aston Martin really well because it sounds awesome. So, I think that is it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to end it here. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye, guys.